Welcome to the Ascendo Traders Group, and this is our trade plan for Tuesday, March 11th, AscendoTraders.com, effective trade plans delivered daily, and let's go ahead and begin. So we're going to review our open positions, review our flag list, review our watch list, set stops and alerts, check news, and you can see tomorrow we basically have trade balance and there's no earnings tomorrow. But if you remember, was it 2 weeks ago when we had days when there wasn't supposed to be any big news, and suddenly we had unexpected news released left and right, so every day. So even though we don't have a lot of news scheduled for tomorrow before the market, certainly anything can come out and move the market. We're going to check the indices, scan for new trades, set alerts for those new trades, and then we're going to go and have life. So let's go ahead and start off by looking at our flag list. Okay, so we're going to start off with our flag list, and what a nice day we had, huh? the market basically kind of started off really quick on the down note, on a sour note, and basically remained that way for the rest of the day. So we, all of our put plays that we had from last night really ended up doing pretty well. So here's our NASDAQ, and we talked about this trend line kind of going here and a falling three pattern here. Even though the volume's not that much higher than yesterday, certainly the NASDAQ's looking weak. The Dow Jones, and the thing that's interesting about the Dow Jones is if we go with our time frame here, back in January, here's our low, and we're about 100 points away from this low, so we have a little bit more to go, but the bottom definitely looks like it's getting ready to fall out the Dow, if it hasn't already. I mean, look at this move, and same thing here with the SPX. We're just a couple dollars away from this January low here. So even though we don't have a higher volume today, the market just, the way someone put it today was that the market was just lazy and pooped out. And we don't, as we talked about, we don't have any news tomorrow. We don't have any news until Thursday. So it's definitely going to be interesting to see what happens as we move forward. Here's Boeing. And the reason I'm keeping Boeing flagged is because we're at a key support level here. So if it breaks this support level, we possibly can continue to move lower. So I'm going to keep it flagged. Plus, it broke, it came right back into the downtrend area. So I'm keeping that one flagged. Bear Stearns. If you haven't got in, I would put an alert around $59, keeping it flagged because look at this volume. Look at that volume. Wow. I heard some things today. Someone shared with me a moment ago that CNBC said they don't even know why Bear Stearns exists. So that's a wow. So I'm keeping that one flagged. CF broke the 50. That was our entry. Certainly looks like it's got some more room to go. To come down here to this $90 range. We've got some chatter going on here, some noise going on here, but we do have an increased volume, so I would go with an alert, 50 cents to a dollar below where we are. Fizzler, we talked about it filling this gap, and it did fill the gap, and now we've got this support around 170. So if you're not in, I'll put an alert right around here about 170 and 50. FWLT, really only flagging it because the volume went down and we've got this going on here. So great move. But when you had a day like this, you got to start differentiating on how you're going to eliminate stocks. So I did unflag FWLT. Obviously, I'm going to unflag IBM, still in this consolidation range. Notice that we did have an update. But we'll see. MOS, how the tide has changed. Broke the 50. Certainly it seemed like it could come down here to 85, if not $70. So I put an alert 50 cents to a dollar below today's low. MTL has not fallen that much compared to other stocks. So certainly go with an alert at the wick to head down to the 50. PBR broke the 50 today. Could head down to 95. Some chatter around 100, psychological support, but put an alert below today's low. RIO, also we've got some chatter going on. See all these wicks here, all these wicks. So this is another one. The only reason I'm keeping the flag is the volume went up. But anybody knows me knows I don't like to trade stocks below $30. So I'm going to unflag it. I am going to unflag it. Some power, I unflagged it mainly because while the rest of the market just tanked, it gave us these small candles. So I unflagged it just because of the move. WHR, we're still at this key support at $81. So keep your alert there and see if we can break lower. WLT, possibly getting the downfall. So put an alert at the 20 to see if we can fall down to the 50. And X went up, starting to form a channel here, maybe from 95 to 115. So certainly could see if it's going to break this range. I put up my alert around 102 to see if it's going to come all the way down here to 95. So that's our flag list for today. And that's our flag list from last night. And we added a couple stocks to that. Let's go down. Added CAT. Like the fact that it broke back down into the downtrend. We've got some strong support at 67.50. So I put an alert here because if it breaks this, it could fall out. CNX, we used to love this. Now that it failed breaking higher, sitting at the 20, put a low below the 20, see if it can fall down to the 50. CF, I think that was already on our list. CHK, same things, at the 20, put an alert below the 20, see if it can fall down to the 50. Goldman Sachs, this is that uptrend line from 06. This is where it all started to go up. So if it breaks this 155.50 range, it certainly could fall out. So put an alert around 155. Joy G, sitting at the 50. Put an alert below the 50 to fall down lower. What's new? Pot has come down. Certainly a good bracket trade stock here. If it breaks below our uptrend line, it already broke the 50. So I put alert around 141.50, 141.75. And RIG, just to put an oil stock in here. Oil's up to $107. Not sure why the oil stocks went down. But we got a key support here, 1131. So put an alert there to see if it could break lower. And that is it. I talked fast because you guys know with YouTube I try to get out there. Had a couple honorable mentions with Google, just from the standpoint of, let's try that one more time. Google? Nope. Google, just from the standpoint of, the support that was here, this head and shoulders neck pattern going on here, it broke that. Another one that we've talked about in the past is dry shipping. And just that we broke through, so we've got some room to go to get down here to this range. Volume increase. So those are a couple of honorable mention stocks. If you're into scalping or swing trading tomorrow, remember the staples used to be brokers back in the day. Of recent, it's been oil, gold stocks, and materials, agriculture. So if the market is up today, because certainly we push down. And you want to do something very risky and play the update and scalp it or swing trade it real quick, go back to those sectors, oil, gold, and materials. And because gold is even down, and it shouldn't be because, the dollar continues to go down. So those are some stock sectors that I will look at if you're interested in playing an update tomorrow. But remember, cash is king. Cash is a position. So let's keep it. So I will talk to you guys later. Thank you for watching. SendoTraders.com, effective trade plans daily. I will As always, remember to trade at your own risk, and I will talk to you guys later. Thanks again. Good night.